Hey guys, good morning. So it's a wonderful, energetic Sunday morning, and let's start this morning again with a knowledge session where we can learn something and start implementing that. That will give us a lot of energy, a lot of zeal, because it is empowering ourselves. So with this, let's start with today's topic. The topic is money likes to travel. Have you been a good host to lodge it? So all of us know that money keeps traveling. And to lodge it, we have to acquire the skill that makes it comfortable to stay with somebody who's really deserving it. So let's understand how it starts. And today we also have a special webinar guest, Mr. Yash, who runs Oho Paisa. He'll be giving us a lot of valuable insights into this topic. With that, let's begin. Just give me a yes to begin with. So everybody, I know that everybody is in there. So again, I welcome all of you. Money likes to travel. Have you been a good host to lodge it? This is the flow of events, how we'll be following it. We'll be understanding the old money system, the new system, and the propaganda behind it. The traps that all of us fall into, and best money practices, and of course, a valuable insight from Mr. Yash, who's running Oho Paisa. So with this, let us begin this session. I would like to tell you that we'll begin from an historical age where how the money system ran. This is very essential to know how things have changed and how we can adapt to this change. So what was the first, very first system of transaction that was invented? It was nothing but barter system. Imagine I am owning a bakehouse and I bake bread and somebody else has wheat. We exchange bread and wheat. And imagine somebody else is having cattle and I exchange my services for milk. This is how things went on. But it had its own constraints. What were they? The major constraint being, if I am baking something, I would definitely want to find a person who can give me grains, because that's the only way of transaction. It was called mutual coincidence, meaning to say what I am selling, trying to sell, and what the other person services is there, both has to match. This gave rise to two, three complications. Complication one being, as I said, both the consensus have to be agreed upon. Point number two being, there was no real means to store what I had. For example, how many bags of grain could I store? Or for example, if I was a milk vendor, how many liters of milk can I store to say that I'm wealthy or I'm rich? So here came a new revolution. What was that? We came into an era where coins came into existence. Coins not only helped us establish a standard system of transaction, but also gave us a means to store it. For example, as I said, I cannot store 100 gallons of milk and say, yes, I have so much of wealth. But yes, I can definitely save up money in the bank and say I'm wealthy, right? So with this, the trades and services started in a much more seamless manner, where money started transaction, and money was where people started saving, people started investing, and here was where there was a lot of change in the dynamics in terms of society. Why? Because it gave rise to something called accumulation. Money could be accumulated. Since it was standardized, people started accumulating money, and due to this, there were large variation in the society that started happening, which wasn't there in the barter system, because things couldn't be stored in that large volume. But yes, things changed when money came into existence. So with this, I would just like to ask everybody this very question. It's called the mystery of same start point. It says all of us started with the same. For example, if I have to tell you, all of us had the same schooling in terms of same education, and we started off with same career. Imagine a situation where you have colleagues who started and spent considerable amount of time in an organization. But the mystery of same starting point says after 10-15 years, there is a large difference in the way how wealth is accumulated between these two or three individuals who started at the same point. So what changed? What really happened? If we could really try to understand what changed and why this is happening, the main thing being, many people have interacted with many people asking this. They say luck. He was lucky enough. He got into this. He got into that. And all other things, except for the matter of fact, they don't accept the fact that they fail to notice the laws that govern the building of wealth. Do you agree? It is because of the reason, only one reason being, people have not understood the laws that govern wealth building. If we go back to our education system, we are not taught on these basic fundas where we understand how to build wealth, but rather on career building, on skills that we work on right throughout our ages, but never understand how to get rich or get wealth accumulated. So here is the mystery of same start point, which can be solved by only one means, by focusing our energy, our effort into learning the laws that counts wealth building. And when I say these are laws, these are the same laws that have governed 6,000 years ago. It's the same laws still exist. If I have to give you the example of this, the richest city in the world, Babylon, was the richest city. And most of you have heard of the Hanging Gardens of Babylon. If we just see the geography of this place, we understand it is an arid land, a deserted place in Iran. And what we understand is, despite all odds, this city turned out to be the wealthiest city. And what were the laws that these people understood, which they discovered and held with them? What was the secret behind this? This we'll discover in this session. And with this, I can say all of us can become wealthy. It is definitely possible. It is just the wisdom of Babylon that we have to apply upon in this present age with the changing dynamics. So what were the laws? If I have to talk to you about the laws, there are seven basic laws that govern. When I state to you all these seven laws, this might seem very common to you. But the basic difference comes when you start applying it. That is where the mystery of the same starting point comes into play. So what were the laws? If I have to tell you, pay yourself first. This is the majority of the people follow the funda of they earn, we spend, and then we save, right? How many of you agree with that? I've been in that cycle for about 2-3 years when I started my first job. But later on, the discovery that has to be made is you pay yourself first. All the toil that you make at the office, all the work that you put in, all the extra hours you put in, it's for who? It's for ourselves first. So who is the deserving one? Is it the restaurant owner who cooks you pasta, or is the person who is working for yourself? It's the person who works for yourself. So pay yourself first. That's the basic law that people 6,000 years ago followed. What is the next thing that we understand? When we pay ourselves, the next parameter that can be changed is controlling the expense. This will be taken in depth in the last section of this presentation, where I'll show you the five fund method that can be opted by every one of us, each one of us. There is no rocket science to this. This is very simple. It just requires your disciplined efforts, and it will be fun because it works with the modern mindset of how we spend. Build the army of labor. This is one of the favorite topics that I love to talk to you. What happens when you build the army of laborers? Am I asking you to employ people? I'm not asking you to employ people here, but I'm asking you to take a concept into your hand and start utilizing it, where money starts working for you. How do you make money work for you? It is only through first step of paying yourself that you start building the army of laborers for you. That is, money starts multiplying itself for you. But it doesn't happen by its own way. You need to ask it to do it for you. And that we shall discover in our section, last section, where Mr. Yash will take us through these instruments. So here is the concept of compounding, which we'll explore in depth at the last section. Guard the treasure. Every penny that you earn has to be guarded. There is no other person than you who can guard it. I see most often people just put away money and they don't get the pain of it. But when you understand the power of compounding, each one of you will understand that every 100 rupees matters, every 1000 rupees matters, because this money is laboring for you. And this money is part of your army that will make you wealthy. For example, if I had to give my own example, I, in the initial years of my career, have lost a lot of money because I didn't guard it. For example, I put in a lot of money into a business where I lost. And at this point, why this topic makes me more interested to guide you all is, I've gone through all the stages, 7 stages, which has been stated here, and experienced each of it at the closest practical way possible. That's the reason I strongly believe whatever I'm saying is through experience, and this will connect to you. Own your own house. When you say own your own house, everybody of us should have roof on top of our head. This gives us 2 benefits. One is that it allows us to plan our finances better. If you don't still have a home for yourself, we'll figure out the ways how we can achieve this goal. And ensure a future income. When I say ensure a future income, all of us are born in this earth and pass through the life stage till we get old, unless God calls upon us. So what here I am trying to express to you is, the birth and death cycle are certain, but we are never sure when death will happen. So at this stage, all of us should also ensure a future income for our family. This not only gives us a good, secured frame of mind to start building and accumulating wealth, but also keeps us going in the hunt to generate more wealth. So the last one is, increase the ability to earn. How do we increase the ability to earn? This is very interesting. You upskill yourself to a certain stage where you start exchanging your skill and earning more money. And this is the way how most people have reached to a pinnacle stage where they say, this is my skill and this is what I'm trading for money. And this is the 7th and the most important skill that everybody has to acquire. Now let's understand the new system. This topic has really been very close to me, and it has given me a different aspect to looking at things. Now, at this stage, I would like to tell you, I request you to be open and change your frame of mind to what I'm presenting to you, because it will conflict with your existing values. So let me narrate to you a story of a village, a story of a small village which had a lot of people in it, had a lot of landlords, had farmers, had cobblers, milkmen, everybody, and the village was running smoothly. So what would happen in due course of months, few farmers would need extra seeds, extra fertilizers. They would go up to the landlords and ask for them to lend them loans. And this is how they used to produce their yield. Sell the yield, give the landlord his share of money and interest. So things ran in a very smooth manner. But after a few months, what would happen is, there were a few defaulters and there were few ill treatment of the landlords and the borrowers. At this stage, there came a man called, let's name him Mr. Thakur. Mr. Thakur came into the system and he said he spotted an opportunity. What opportunity did he spot? He spotted something where he could formalize the structure for both the lender and the borrower. So what did Mr. Thakur do? Mr. Thakur said, okay, money lender, landlord, okay, you give me your money, let me give you good interest rates on it. And he went to the people borrowing and he said, okay, you need money, I'll give you at this interest rate. So what Mr. Thakur did is, Mr. Thakur spotted an opportunity in an unorganized sector and established a system called banking system. He used to take money from the lenders, give them X interest rate, lend it to the borrowers at X plus 2, and the 2% extra was what he earned. And in this course of cycle, Mr. Thakur understood, yes, I'm making a lot of money. and I'm not actually doing anything. Things are happening for myself. So he established a system where he started promoting people to taking loans. Initially, it started with taking crop loan, home loans, which happened. But at certain point, Thakur realized something important. He realized that the loans that were given were temporary. It was only once. How long could a person take loan to build a house? Once in his lifetime. How long could he take to buy a tractor or a cattle? Once in his lifetime, or probably twice. So he entered a state of roadblock. So what was the next thing Mr. Thakur could do? He went into the age-old system, the law that the Babylonian age used. He said, I'll build an army of laborers who will work for me and make me rich. And this is how he entered into a cycle of providing loans to everybody into their day-to-day use. If I have to take our own example, what are the one-time loans that we can avail? Can I have this answer for everybody? What are the one-time loans that most of us can avail in our lifetime?
Housing loan.
Housing loan. What else?
Probably the vehicle loan also, may I add.
Vehicle loan, maybe education loan. So these are the loans that we take in once in our life. But what did Mr. Thakur think of? Can these make Mr. Thakur rich? It cannot. So he came up with a concept where he said, I will make loan a part of everybody's day-to-day life. I'll repeat the statement. He said, I'll come with a concept where I'll make loan part of everybody's day-to-day life. Now, how is this possible? Can it become a part of everyday's life cycle? It has in fact become, and Thakur has established it. How has he established it? He has just established this concept by two systems of this thing. One is the EMI system that all of us have fallen into. I'm lucky to escape it from the last 2 years. And the credit card system that has been brought into. Why these have been brought into? If Mr. Thakur has to become rich, what will he do? He has to ensure everybody does credit transaction on a day-to-day basis, right from grocery, right from buying a small electronic equipment, right from anything in life. So he started with the concept of EMI and credit card transactions. So what did that make for him? It ensured Mr. Thakur entered into a automatic mode where we started laboring for him. Whom am I referring to? All of us who have fallen into this trap. In this way, what happens is all of us are in the trap of Mr. Thakur's and laboring for him and giving him a lifestyle that he wants. Now, just a question. Can we replicate the law that Babylonian age used, the law that governs by making money labor for us? Can we do it? It is possible for us. We'll discover that here. But this concept really make a difference into you. Did you understand what Mr. Thakur is establishing and what the modern society is trying to do? Now, if I ask you to, let's proof check it. Let's proof check what I was trying to tell you. This is the screenshot of HDFC Bank, where I went into the borrowing section and I took a screenshot of what they have. So what do they have? Let's count the number of products they have. How many products?
22 to 23.
Close to 23. So let's again explore something very interesting now. Let's enter into the savings section where these things make us wealthier. How many of these?
Nine.
So does it really tell you what the concept of Mr. Thakur, how the things have changed from old age to the new age and the propaganda behind it? Here, everybody is trying to utilize the fact of compounding, the banking system, everybody. And if we want to become wealthy, even we have to follow the system that the banking system is following, to making an army of labor work for us. Here, by the term labor, I mean money work for us. Let's again check it. Any incidents from your personal life? Anybody? I'll give you an incident which happened 5 years ago when I started working. So when I had to open a bank account, when I joined a company, they asked me to open a savings account. And the next thing that they said is, this is a privileged HDFC credit card. Why don't you buy it? Your movie tickets will be discounted. Your fuel will be discounted. Your vacations will be discounted. Have you been there, most of you? But the same person, same person doesn't ask you to say, sir, why don't you start a FD or an RD with me? Or why don't you invest in this PFA account? Or why don't you invest in this security fund, which will give you a good return? Connecting? The reason being, Mr. Thakur will not get rich by telling you to open savings account. Mr. Thakur will get rich by doing what? By asking you to take various sort of different loans that he can offer you and making you a part of his army. The only way how he can earn more is making you part of his army. So these are various things that will really open up your vision and thought process to various activities that are happening in the world. If you ideally just open up the advertisement board of anything, you will see more of loan products than any other products telling you to save and get wealthy. I'm very sure all of you will test this from now on TV advertisement, on any other media, when this is happening. But let's play a game. What we have understood is, we have understood one, the old system, the new system, and the propaganda, what is happening to all of us. And here I will take you to the solution phase. Right now we'll start discussing solution towards it. When we know what is really happening in the world, you have to be aware of solutions. Let's play a game. I want somebody to pick 5 words out of all of these. Yeah, so five words. Can anybody just pick them and spell it out?
Happiness.
Okay.
Health.
Okay.
Friends, okay. Family, career.
Great. And can I have a second volunteer who can do the same?
Freedom. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah. So freedom, security, growth, independence, peace of mind.
Peace of mind. Wonderful. So right here, we had two different discussions here. Somebody chose 5 other different things. Somebody else chose 5 other different things. What essentially we are trying to establish here is, these are your value systems. These are your value systems that drive you. These not only drive you in each day, it determines how you behave, what actions you take, and the choices that you make every second in your life. For example, if somebody told growth, security, the same thing shall reflect in the financial aspect. If after the session, you might just take a time off and try to reflect upon this fact that the value really drives you. If somebody had said fun, excitement, their finance and life will also reflect in the same manner. If somebody said security, peace of mind, career, their finance and the lifestyle will also reflect in the similar lines. Because finance always is a byproduct of your action. It cannot be changed. So I hope this really made sense to you. So the next section where we'll be talking is, we'll be talking about something called the value system of everybody. To start your financial journey, to start a journey towards wealth creation, your inner values should change. If you have a different value which is not aligning to your goals, it will definitely not make you reach where you want. So how does this vary? It is become, do, and have. If I have to tell you, Become is you identify your value systems and stick to it. Then the actions that you take based on your value system. And third is have. These actions will give you the material things that you want. But in the later slides, we'll discover how this order is changing. Is it become, do, have, or have, become, do, or have, do, and become? Just hold on for a second here. I'll clarify this in the coming slides and you'll get more clarity on this. So what is the next trap? If I have to speak to you on next trap that all of us fall into, I would like to make a differentiation between something called rich and wealthy. Is rich being same as wealthy?
No.
Definitely not. Rich, any person having good bank balance can be called rich. But can he be called wealthy? He cannot. There is a difference to this concept. I would like to make this difference from, can everybody Google for frugality in Google? The first thing that everybody gets when you Google for frugality. I'm doing it myself. Yeah, what did you get when you Googled for frugality? The quality of being economical with money or food. Yes. Why I asked all of you to Google for frugality is this exactly defines us what rich and wealthy do. The rich and wealthy always measure things in terms of frugality. Frugality doesn't mean somebody is a miser. There is a distinction between miser and frugality. If you look at the right side photo that I have put in, people who tend to be rich or try to show rich do not have actual net worth of anything. Everything around them are something which are leaking their pockets. But the same person, if you consider somebody to be wealthy, you will see a greater net worth. But you might not see anything that is trying to actually elevate your status. If, for example, 5 years back when I started joined my job, the first thing I did was buy a bike, buy a phone, buy things that I just did not actually need at that hour. Though I had a bike, though I had a phone. So what did I try doing? I tried replicating the right side image. I tried replicating something where things elevated my social status, but nearly did not elevate my net worth, not at all. But the same person, if for example, all of you who have understood things now, you can fall into your left side of the category where you can say my net worth is more and I do not have to show off things to others. So here there is something called conspicuous and non-conspicuous consumption. If everybody were part of my first webinar, you will appreciate that conspicuous consumption is something that actually do not have any utility value. They have minimal utility value, but they have a lot of prestige related status quo. For example, a person can wear a watch. The same person can also wear an expensive watch. So what I'm trying to tell is conspicuous consumption will increase your prestige, but will not increase the actual utility of the device that is giving to you and will decrease your net worth. Now let's move to the next important thing, laboring for the bank. If I am very sure everybody is clear by now that we should as soon as possible exit through this trap where we are laboring for the bank. By this, what I mean is try avoiding all the loans. And at this point, when I say avoiding the loans, few people with business mindset might tell me, Vinayak, I do not agree with you. I am with you. I will say I am actually with the idea, but everybody should understand something called good and bad loans that we'll discuss at the question answer session. So bad loans have to be avoided because bad loans will only make you a labor to the bank. And what the last and the best thing, we should avoid the leaks that all of us have in our pockets. What are these leaks? We have identified all of those in this segment, especially all the traps has to be avoided. Once the leak are avoided, the same bucket that you have will be filled right throughout the year. But if you have leakages, whatsoever, how many hours of work you do, how many hours of toiling you do, it will never be as full as the one which has no leakage into it. So let's come to the last section where I would express to you the best practices, and most of you are interested into this. So if I have to tell you a statement that might again offend you, your salary, I'll say our salary, is the biggest source of income, right? Agreed? Except for the fact if somebody is into business and already established, right? So our salary is the biggest source of income to all of us. And the thing that we have to take care is, we have to ensure we utilize this in the best possible way. So how do we utilize this? Let me start off with a Maslow's hierarchy triangle, where it says, when we understand this, I'll correlate the same concept to finance. What it says, it exactly says that first is the psychological needs of food and safety that everybody wants, right? Then we go on to a safety aspect. Then we go on to a social structure of love and being loved. Then we go to the esteem section and self-actualization. So the same aspect, do we follow it in the financial structure? If I leave somebody in a new city, they will try this Maslow's hierarchy. But the same thing doesn't apply to finance. Do you relate? The same thing doesn't really apply. Nobody takes care of their safety. They just go to the esteem section and start doing things. If I have to give you the same chart in terms of finance, the first is me. If I want to accumulate wealth, if I have to become wealthier, what are the most important things? It's me. I'm the most important thing. I have to be healthy and I have to live longer. Do you agree? If I live for next 20 years, the amount of wealth that I create might be X. But if I live for next 40 years, what would be the wealth I can create? Maybe 3X, right? So the most fundamental aspect of everything in the creation of wealth is us. We have to be healthy and we have to be living as long as possible. So this, I will come to the solution phase of it, how to address to it. The next is safety. As I said, the next step, when it is safety, our finances should be diverted in a way where it is safe. The law that I read in the book, The Richest Man in Babylon, said, you should always protect your principal amount. Never get into investments that threaten your principal amount. That's the safety net that we work under. Then we come into the risk category where we say we have enough safety net. Now it's time to invest in riskier instruments. That my friend Yash will be covering each of the instrument in detail. So I'm not really diving into it right now. At the later stages comes wants. What are wants? All the expensive things that we want, all the vacation that we desire, all these things that do not fall into the need category. So having said this, at what stage are you at? Are you at the pay yourself stage, controlling expense stage, building the army of labor, guarding the treasure, owning your own house, ensuring a future income, or increasing the ability to earn? At what stage are you at? Everybody, I would like to hear it from you so that we can truly work out on things.
I believe at controlling in the expenses.
Controlling in the expenses. What else? So what I would be sharing is, I would be sharing here, point number one, pay yourself first. Point number two, controlling your expense. And point number three, building your army. And point number six, ensuring a future income. So how do we start with this? To start with this, I will introduce to you a five fund method that I have been using for the last 3 years, and it has been fabulous for me in terms of how it has helped me lessen the complication. And in fact, things happen when you follow this method. What does the five fund method say? The five fund method says all of us should operate with five accounts. If I have to ask you, how many accounts do you hold right now? What would be the answer? How many accounts do you operate with? One, two,
one two or
accounts.
Two
accounts, great. 4. Awesome. So what? Let me present to you the two accounts. Great. So all right, let me tell you how this 5-fund account really helps you. The 5-fund account really helps you in the manner that will give you the freedom and will not put you into that budgeting constraint. See, budget is a really tiresome thing. If you really get into the budgeting aspect of things, keeping track of each penny that you spend, it will not only drain your energy, it will make you frustrated and you will not stick to it. How many of you have tried budgeting? That actual budgeting where you start entering things, it will not stick with you. So here is a method which will stay with you for a longer time because this is fun. What you do is the financial freedom account is the first account that you create. See, everybody has a salary account. Forget about the salary account. That can be later converted into a necessity account. I'll come to it. So once the salary comes, the first thing that we do is we transfer it into an account called financial freedom account. We transfer 10% of the fund to financial freedom account. When is this to be done? This will be done as soon as the salary hits. And post this, financial freedom account accounts for what? What do we spend this money for? We do not spend this money. Point number one, we invest this money into instruments that we'll discuss. And financial freedom account is something where we are doing the concept of paying ourselves first. We never spend this money. Remember this point. Never ever will this money be spent. Why will this money not be spent? Because it's for your greater future. But the second account that we all have to operate it is with an emergency account. Most of you, when I say emergency, they'll never distinguish between an emergency and a situation. When is an emergency? Emergency is a real situation when you are in dire need of money to protect something. Maybe life, could be your health, or could be somewhere where you're in a real tragic situation where money is needed. So emergency account says for a fact that at least you should be having a year of expenditure with you in this account, a year's expenditure. So if somebody is earning some 60,000 to 70,000, at least a year's expenditure, meaning so say if somebody has a monthly expense of 20,000 to 25,000, into a year's expense has to be in the emergency fund. And now I'll tell you the beauty of financial freedom account and emergency account is that both of these accounts should be created in a bank where you don't have debit card facility, where you have not taken internet banking facility, and you have not taken checkbook facility. Now you'll say, Vinayak, you have gone crazy. I'll say this is the means how you keep yourself under check. Now what is the advantage of not having a checkbook, net banking facility, nor a debit card?
Maybe it tempts us to utilize that whenever, like if we are too much spending our money, and in case if the balance which we are having has fallen low, then at that time we may think that, oh, okay, anyway, yeah. I have a checkbook facility, let's go and take out the money from it.
Definitely. Human mind is naturally, through this process, we are toughening the mind, we are not letting it be weak. So when we know to get this amount, I have money, I need extra 20,000, but to need this, I have to spend, I have to take a days off, I have to go to the bank, I have to fill the form, pay slip and get the money. These four steps will tell you, nay, I'll better adjust the situation. Do you understand this? So this, in a way, you're trying to toughen your mind to the situation. And this is how you actually do not keep. You make these accounts without all of these. So now we have covered something called financial freedom account, emergency fund account. So emergency fund account will grow in a period of time. It will not happen at once and it takes time. Once this is done, we go into the best part, which is called the fun account. Fun account being, as we said, all of us are humans. We start putting in 10% of our every month's earning into this. So in a matter of 3 or 4 months, it will accumulate to a good amount. And after that, each month, whenever you go out, you just have this fun account debit card with you. You say, okay, I have 20,000. This is my restaurant and I am able to have this much. So each time when your friend says, let's go on a vacation, what will you do? Which account will you access? You'll say, you'll just check your fun account. You'll say, yes, I have another 15,000 left. I can go out on a vacation. So you go out on a vacation. You have fun. But again, this fun account ends when there is zero amount into it. So also this is keeping you in check how much you spent or even in your vacation or your fun time, right? Good way. Now let's come to something called sinking fund account. Sinking fund accounts are account that is created for your big purchases. Any big purchases, again, you start putting 10% of your income into this. Anything, it might be your desire to buy a vehicle, a phone, any of these sorts. The sinking fund account will keep you very disciplined in terms of buying things. And again, for this, what I urge you to do, again, do not have any of the cards. Just have net banking facility, no debit card, no checkbook. So next comes necessity account. This is where 60% of your money stays. You can convert your salary account itself into a necessity account. What you do, you have access to debit card, you have access to all things that will help you spend and live a month, take you through a month in a comfortable manner. Now, what is the advantage? Let us try to understand. This is the exact screenshot of what I have lifted from the book. The book being Master Your Money, Master Your Life, a fantastic book. It gives you insights through very commonsensical manner, nothing complicated. Most people say finance is complicated, but I urge everybody to go through this book, The Richest Man in Babylon, and this book, Master Your Money and Master Your Life. Very simply given, and you will start enjoying the results of it when you start practicing. So this is what I have explained to you. We have to create five funds: financial freedom account, emergency fund, sinking fund, fun account, necessity account, and divide the fund in this manner. And when do you actually start doing this? The best question: when do you start transferring money to this?
Immediately.
As soon as you get your this thing. And if you have seen, if you just ask any of my family members, they'll say the next 2 hours, as soon as he gets his salary, he is not to be seen. Why? I'm doing all these things. I'm running around. I feel my time bomb inside my head has gone on, and I have to accomplish this. So I ensure all these five funds are created so that my next 28 days or 30 days of the month are flawless. I have my necessity account. I have my card. I know how much is to be spent, and I'll do it. And always don't have your Google account tagged to all of these. Google Pay, just tag it to your necessity account. That's how things will keep you in check. And this is what I had to share with you all. And I will welcome Mr. Yash to the presentation, where he'll give you deeper insights into all of these instruments. And it will be a technical session that will help you. And at the end, we'll have a question answer session on all the topics discussed. I would request you to make a note of it so that we will have a interactive session and get to a conclusion. So Yash, I would welcome you.
Thank you so much, Vinayaka. First of all, thankful to Book Hypothesis for collaboration, and good morning to all. And I've done my master's in finance and business analytics. And I've been managing Ohu Paisa since last 1 year. I've started it with a aim. Let me share the slide. Let me know whether it is visible or not. Vinayaka?
Hello?
It's not visible at...
It's not visible.
Now?
No, still not. Can you present or take that option right corner?
Now is it visible?
No, Ash. Is it visible to anyone else?
No.
Okay.
No, it is not.
Yes, now we can see it. Yeah.
Now?
Yes, we can see it. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. So, friends, I have started Ohu Paisa 1 year ago with the aim. 1 minute. So, hello, friends. I have started Ohu Paisa 1 year ago with the aim to promote financial literacy. Now, what is financial literacy and why it is important to you? So, Financial literacy is something which gives you knowledge and required skills to manage your money effectively. And now, why is financial literacy is important? Financial literacy is important because regardless whatever profession you are into, whether you are a student or a housewife, but in a day, somewhere, somehow you are dealing with and managing your money. And by default, we are expected to manage it effectively. And until unless you are an MBA or CA graduate, no one has taught you how to manage money effectively. So here, financial literacy comes into the picture, which can gives you necessary knowledge and required skills, which will help you to manage your money effectively. And friends, do you know that money is the only tool which can take you wherever you wish for, but it can't replace you as a driver? Means you have to drive your money to reach your financial goal. How you can drive your money, we'll understand in the coming slides. So at the end of this presentation, you will be able to understand and answer what is Indian financial market and how it is important to you, and why you should save and invest. And the important concepts are time value of money and the power of compound interest, and different investment options available to you, and what are the risk and return trade-off in the investing, and how you can save against those risks in the market. And the second part will be the implementation. I will explain you how you can start investing now and important do's and don'ts of investing, and best investment you could do ever. And this investment is 100% risk-free and 100% assured return. So we'll discuss that. Then we'll learn from some experts and their experiences. Then things you can start doing from today onwards. And one good money habit to manage your emotions. And at last, we have some bonus tips which will help you to travel your financial journey smoothly. Let's begin with, what is financial system? Financial system has four components in it. One, financial institutions, financial markets. Third one is financial instruments and financial services. Now, what financial system do? Financial system allows exchange of funds between the lenders and investors and the other side borrowers, where lenders and investors seek return on their investment, and borrowers fulfill their short-term and long-term financial need by taking money and pay interest on that. Let's get deep into the financial market. To explain you financial market, I would like to tell you one story of Mr. Smart. As he is very smart, he have a financial goal to buy a house at when he retire. To fulfill his financial goal, he need some money. As of now, he don't have money. So on the right hand side, you can see his financial goal of Mr. Smart. And on the left hand side, you can see where he stands today. And he have only one source of income. As he is very smart, he went to the market to get a vehicle which he need to reach his financial goal. As there are many vehicles available in the market. So the choice of vehicle is depends on Mr. Smart's ability to ride and the distance he need to cover. Let's back to our point. Similarly, financial market will offer you different vehicles to reach your financial goal. Like we can name them as equity, mutual fund, debt instruments, and bank FDs. Now, financial market is simply gives you access to different investment vehicles to put your money and reach your financial goal. And the choice of vehicle is based on your riding capacity and the distance you need to travel. So here, Mr. Smart will travel and reach his financial goal based on his riding capacity. In the next slide, we'll tell you why should you need to invest. So here also we'll take an example of Mr. Smart. First, let me explain you what this table shows. This table shows goals of Mr. Smart, that he want to go for vacation to France in 2023. And today, if he invest, today if he go, it cost him 5 lakh rupees. And the next column is amount after inflation. So for the people who don't know what inflation is the increase in the price of goods and services over a period of time in an economy because of change in the price of raw material and the required products. So today, if it cost him 5 lakh rupees, so after 3 years, in 2003, it will cost him 5,96,000. Here I've taken 6% annual inflation on an average. So these are some of Mr. Smart's goal. So he has only one source of income. Does it is sufficient to fulfill all these goals? Absolutely not. So what he could do, he has to increase his income streams. So what all income streams are available? First, earned income. Second, profit income. Third, interest income. And likewise, these 8 incomes are. So what all incomes by investing you can create? And Mr. Smart, he can earn from job, he can earn salary. Second one, profit. By buying and selling, he can earn profit. Third, by investing in different investment option, he can earn interest. Fourth one is capital income. When he owns financial assets by investing, when an asset increases in value, then he can earn also capital income. Dividend income, when he owns stock of a company and company declares a dividend, then he can earn dividend income. And the rental income, if Mr. Smart invests in real estate and use that as a source of income, so he will also able to earn rental income. Then royalty income, when someone uses Mr. Smart's patent right and the idea of Mr. Smart, so he is entitled to receive royalty on that. So another source of income. Residual income is something which people can earn at the age when they reach the financial freedom. It is something when you get paid after the work is done. So that is not a part of Mr. Smart's income. So by investing, Mr. Smart is entitled to receive first five. Now earlier, what Mr. Smart has? One source of income. Now how many source of income Mr. Smart has? 5 source of income by investing along with this salary. So what Mr. Smart did, that he makes his money to work. Now how he can make his money to work? He can't say money, go and get the return. Instead, what he could do, he could invest it and get it and give it time to grow and fulfill his financial goal. That's the conclusion of Mr. Smart's story, that he should invest that and give it time to grow, to reach his financial goal. Now next, I will explain you some important concepts like time value of money. So what is time value of money? The amount which is available to you present is worth more. The same amount is available to you the future. Means 100 rupees is available to you today, and the same 100 amount after 2025 is not much worth equal to, because money has the earning capacity. Let's understand this with an example. If I have 10 lakh rupees today, I will invest in FD and earn 5% return on that. So in the next year, I will be having 10,50,000 rupees. So if I don't have 10 lakh rupees, I'm going to lose the 50,000 rupees which I would have earned if I invest somewhere. So in the picture, you can see that Mr. Angry is saying that I want my payment today, because if I wait, I lose out on the growth I would have earned. So money has the earning capacity. What money can earn? Money can earn money in terms of interest to reach your financial goals. That's the time value of money. Now it's time to show you some magic. So the magic is the power of compounding. Believe me, this is a magic. Next, what is compound interest? To make you aware of that, I have illustrated this, that in 2020, if I invested 10,000 rupees at a 10% interest, at the end of the year, it will become the 1100. And in the next year starting, I have 1100 rupees to invest. So by the end of the year, 2021, I would have 1210 rupees. So likewise, when your interest start earning interest on that, that's the compounding. When you start getting interest on your interest, principal plus interest. Now, the next picture will be the magic for you and an eye opener for you. Suppose if you start investing at the age of 23 and start investing with the 1000 rupees per month, 1000 rupee investment, and you will continue investing till you get, till you reach 16 without increasing an investment. So then total amount you are investing per year is 12,000 rupees only. Only 12,000 you are investing. And if the annual compounding happens at 16%, because I have taken historic return of Nifty 50, which has given 16% and more than that. So here I have taken 16%. So the total investment you have made is 4,44,000. And the total amount you would have at the age of 60 is 2,71,41,462 rupees. Total wealth you have earned is 2,66,97,462. That's the power of compounding. Just an investment of 4,44,000 will turn into 2,66,97,000. That's a huge amount and will surely give you a life of your dreams. And the best thing is that compounding works even when you are sleeping. So your money is working for your dreams. Your money is working for your financial goals, even when you are sleeping, just by investing it. Now we have understood what compounding is, what time value money is. Let's understand what all are the different investment options available to you for an investment. First, I will explain fixed deposit. A fixed deposit is a financial instrument. Normally, banks and non-banking financial companies provide this service where you have to put in your money for a certain period. And that will be the lock-in period. At the end of the lock-in period or the maturity time, you will get your principal plus interest back. So from FD, you can earn in this way. Next will be the debentures. Debentures are the long-term and medium-term debt instrument. These are debt instrument because organizations who has good credibility in the market, they issue debentures to raise money for fulfilling their purposes. And who is lending to them? We, investors, who are lending to them. And in return, they are issuing us debentures. And at the maturity, they will give us a fixed interest and our principal amount. Next, mutual funds. A mutual fund is a company or an organization who pools money from the different investors who share the same financial goal. And by pooling that money, the mutual fund organization invests that money into different financial securities. Like they will invest some amount in debentures, some fixed deposits, some equity, some real estate, and some in gold. Likewise, they invest, and the combined portfolio of mutual fund company is called, combined holdings of mutual fund organization is called portfolio of there. Next option will be equity, stock, or share. All these three terms are the same. So equity represents the ownership in the organization. To understand equity, let's take an example. If an ABC Limited issued 1,00,000 shares, then if you bought 10,000 shares, then you have 10% equity ownership of the ABC Limited. And when the organization grow, they will give you, as the price of the organization, value of the organization increases, your wealth will be increases along with the organization. Next, real estate. Real estate investing involves purchase, ownership, and rental or sale of real estate property for a profit. And the last option is gold. These are not only the limited options, there are many others are available in the market, but these are the few common ones. So these have, you have understood the different investment options and will take Q&A session if you have any doubt on these options. Next, risk and return. So one thing we normally hear, higher the risk, higher the return. Take the risk, you will get the return. But this is not true in investing. In investing, higher the risk, higher the return. Means higher the risk, higher the expected return, not the guaranteed return. So listen carefully, higher the risk, higher the expected return. If you are willing to take higher risk, then you are increasing your potential earning rate, potential of earning returns, but not getting the assured 100% return. So higher the risk, higher the expected return. So it will be good if you increase your risk-taking ability. That will enhance your probability of earning handsome returns and get enhanced with the highest risk-taking ability. As the risk is a part of every investment, even though your FDs are the risky, if bank goes bankrupt, only one up to 1 lakh. Up to 1 lakh FD is secure. After that, FD is not secure. So how you can safeguard your investment in the market from the market risk? So to understand this, I will explain you my example. I have 1 lakh rupees. I have invested 10,000 in fixed deposit, 20,000 in debentures, 40,000 in equities, 20,000 in mutual fund, 10,000 in gold. So what I did, I diversified investment. I have put my investment in a diversified manner so that I ensure the systematic return. What if I have put all my 1 lakh into the equity only? If the market goes down, my whole story is finished. 1 lakh is completely on a down. That will temper my good night's sleep. It made me worry because I put all my 1 lakh rupees and I'm seeing that it's continuously decreasing. But what if I have diversified my investment, my only 40,000 rupees at risk, my 60,000 is safe. So that's how you can diversify your portfolio and save yourself against the market risk, because market is subject of risk. Investment in markets is subject to market risk. So be diversify your investment and safeguard yourself. That's now you have understood the diversification. You have understood the what are investment. Now how you should start investing? The first thing first comes to here is define your investment goal. Why you want to invest your money? What is your financial goal which you want to achieve? Here two things come into the picture that you should have clarity in your mind for what purpose you are investing, because return, everyone wants return. So you can invest on any option, that doesn't matter. So you should have clarity with your financial goal. You prepare your vision board as Mr. Smart did. He has prepared a proper financial goal, financial vision board, when and how much amount he wants. So define your investment goal. It will help you to choose your investment vehicle. Then next, develop your strategy. Whether you want to achieve your investment goal after how many years, means whether you are going for short-term investment or long-term investment. We have heard the term SIP, Systematic Investment Plan. That's the one thing. But on the other hand side, you should keep in mind Systematic Withdrawal Plan. When you need your money back, because we are not investing forever. We are not investing for a lifelong time, but we are investing for a certain purpose. So for what purpose and when you need your money back, under develop your strategy, you should consider systematic withdrawal plan as well. Then next, research about investment options. Do research before going to meet your financial planner, before going to meet your broker. Go and research something. Everything is available on the internet. Just you need to type and search about the option. You will get every information about it. So you have to search and be wise in your investment decision. Then next, it's important to, if you are not from the financial background, it's important you to consult with your financial advisor to get proper understanding. He will help you to plan your investment. Then choose a broker. There should be someone who can facilitate your transaction. So brokers are there who can facilitate your transactions. Then next one is open necessary account. So for investing in share market, you need to open a DMAT account, or to invest in a mutual fund, you should have a bank account. And in FDs also, you need some accounts. So open the necessary account. So welcome, your investing journey is starting. That's how you can start investing. And why you should start investing, I have explained you earlier. Now, making money in investing will not be difficult if you follow do's and don'ts of investing. So what are the important do's and what are the important don'ts I'm going to disclose here? So first will be get an education. Get an education, need not to go any college, any university. You can simply Google it. You can find every information, which asset class you want to invest, type it. Everything is available over the internet. Download some portals like Money Control, which will give you a quick understanding what the need not to be technical, but you should have fundamental knowledge. You should have basic understanding where you are going to put your money. Next, start with a small amount. Why small amount? Because it will give you a chance to learn from small mistakes. Okay, and start early. Start early because the power of compounding is very huge. I have explained to you before. Next, set your investment goal. Goal is the only thing from where the journey started. From here only, you will decide where you want to invest. Take a long-term view and try to invest consistently. This is completely correlated with compounding. Long-term view will enable compounding and enable you to take advantage of compounding and invest consistently, where along with interest, when you increase your principal amount, your interest on investment will also increase parallelly. Now that's the do's. What you should not to do? You should not to do like, don't take investing as a gambling. Friends, investing is not a gambling. Don't expect your money to double overnight. If you are expecting your money to get double overnight, then you should ready to lose your money overnight. So don't consider investing as a gambling. Next, don't ignore transaction cost. Whenever you make any investment, there is something processing cost, transaction cost. So don't ignore such type of cost because they might lower down your returns. So don't trade frequently, don't invest frequently. Make a wise decision, think before making, and make a decision once or twice and lower down your transaction cost. Then don't take blind risk. Always go with the calculated risk and before investing. As Mr. Vinayaka explained, have an emergency fund account, because to meet the emergency necessities, you should have the emergency fund account, and before taking risk, you should have emergency account. So don't take blind risk. Calculate your risk based on your risk appetite, consult your financial planner, and move ahead. Next, don't panic, because investment market is subject to up and down. As to explain this, when COVID started, market started flattering down. It was a bloodbath in the market, completely red. And now after a few months, it's again reached to the same level. So what? Market is subject to up and down. Investment are subject to market risk. Don't panic if you have invested in a quality investment vehicle. So invest in a quality stocks, quality investment options, and buy right, sit tight. The next, so here things come. The investment option you could ever do is the best investment, where you have 100% assured return without 0% risk. I have said risk is in every investment, but this is the investment where you get zero risk, no risk at all. By investing in yourself is the best investment you can ever make. So how you can make investment in yourself? So here are some most effective ways to invest in self. First, practice to manage yourself within the available time. By doing so, you will be able to get maximum out of the available time and live a quality life. Improve your knowledge and master your existing skills and acquire new ones, because these two things which separates you from the crowd available in the market. So improve your knowledge and master your existing skills and acquire new ones. Next, practice gratitude. What is gratitude? Is simply thanking for a situation. So when you practice gratitude, you will more starting thanking towards the situation and stop complaining. It will keep your mind and your psychology will keep adopting it when you practice gratitude. Next, improve your health, physical plus mental. There is no use of money if you don't have good health. So you should, to enjoy your money, to enjoy your wealth, you should have good health. So first you should invest in yourself, then you should invest in your money. Then next, listen to the knowledgeable person and learn from their experience. To explain this point, I used to listen to Mr. Ramdev Agrawal and Warren Buffett. from their experience, I started my investment journey, because those are the pupils who already invested their 40 to 60 years in the investment market. So by listening to them, I'm learning from their experiences, I'm learning from their mistakes, which I will avoid. I will try to avoid those mistakes in the investment journey. Next. So here we'll learn some of their quotes, what they want to say, what they want to teach us. So first, let's take Mr. Ramdev Agrawal's quote, that when you talk about long-term compounding, the compounding will only happen only by the quality, and if there is no quality, it will flatter. He is simply trying to say, be choosy while picking investment option. Search about it. It's good to wait, and it's good to analyze. It's good to ask question with your financial planner, because be choosy, because you are investing for a long term and you want compounding to happen. So if you have only invested in good investment option, then only compounding will act in your favor. Otherwise, it will not. So you should buy right and sit tight. Now what Mr. Warren Buffett says, if you don't find a way to make your money while you are sleeping, you will work until you die. So I have already told you what, if you are not a CEO or not a person who for whom people who overnight working, so then compounding is the one thing who can work you overnight. He can make your money work for yourself and work for your financial goal. And second one, never depend on a single source of income. Make an investment and create a second source of income. So these are the understandings from these two persons. And next one is, so regardless knowledge you have, regardless investing skills you have, until unless you don't execute them, it not matter at all. So what five things you can do, start from today only. From right now after this webinar, you can start. First, save to invest. Okay, then budget your expenses. Third, shift your money to another account. What Mr. Vinayaka has explained, you can link it to here. That shift your money to another account means to save from your money, because you have the power to spend your money. You have to protect your money first from yourself, then from the other. Then track your expenses. Always it is wise to know where your money is going, whether it is right or wrong. So track your expenses. Next, make a splurging budget. Splurging budget is something you save for things which you not comes under your needs, not comes under your want. It will come under your desires. Like I would like to buy a Rolex watch which will cost me around 150,000. So right now, immediately, I don't have that much fund, but I will start saving towards it under my splurging budget. So these five things you can start doing from today onwards. Next. Okay. So what comes in my mind? What comes in your mind when you see big sale up to 50% off? Buy one, get one free. Should I buy this or should not? No. I should try this. Some these types of statements encounter in our mind when we see these types of advertisement, whenever we go to market, whenever we go to anywhere, buy one get one free, do we actually need this or not, but actually it is available at the lower cost, we tend to buy them. So what to do in this situation, how you can save your money in this situation? So to manage money, managing emotions is must. You have to manage your emotions after seeing such type of ads. So to manage your emotions, what you could do, ask yourself the following three questions. Do I absolutely need this? Will this make my life better? Can I live without this? And I'm sure after asking these three questions, you will get answers of whether you should buy or not. And if not, if you didn't get the answer, then you should delay that particular expense for next 48 hours. And if demand still persists and if you still desire for that, then create a splurging budget for that. That's all about the good money habit to manage money. And at last, bonus for you. Here, I'm going to share these two resources. First is MoneyBhai, India's biggest virtual trading group. They will offer you 1 crore portfolio. So as in real life, we used to invest in share market, FDs or mutual funds, debentures. They will offer you virtual cash and they will give you a platform. Really, it's real. It's linked with real time market. You can invest on BSE 500 stocks. You can invest in any mutual fund. You can invest in debentures. You can invest in fixed deposit. You can also invest in the non-convertible debentures. So you can leverage this platform to learn by practice. So if time permits, I will show you on my screen how you can open and how you can start on MoneyBhai. And the second thing I'll share with you, that Corporate Finance Institute. This is the one-step solution for all your financial queries. They have published so much stuff, so you can enhance your financial IQ, and also you can pursue some free finance certification and to improve on your skills at free of cost. There are some certification which are available at free of cost, and later they charge, but initial some things which are available at free of cost. So that's all.